We have about 364 people in so far. The poll will be closed in 12 seconds. And the numbers increasing.
So kita tunggu 1000 lah baru start.
Welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us for the first slot in our TVET Renoms Resetting Norms webinar today morning. Today we have arranged four webinars that are focusing on content creation and live teaching, best practices. And today, just before we get started, a little housekeeping. If you have any questions during the presentation, please type them into the chat box in your WebEx control panel. I'll bring them up during the presentation, and we will also have time for questions at the end. For those of you who have answered the feedback form after watching the previous sessions, please continue doing so for all the subsequent sessions, as your feedback and reflections of our webinar sessions are really important and valuable. Ladies and gentlemen, carrying out an online class is easier said than done. Now, during this time of movement control order, the hands-on laboratory activities are almost not possible. Students require an alternative learning method to understand certain physical processes of a machine. This can be delivered through a virtual lab. Now, realizing the common challenges lecturers face, today's presenters will be sharing with us step-by-step development of a virtual lab using the native Keynote app in your iPad or in a Mac. Now, they will be showing you that the learning curve to use the app is not that difficult. But what is more important is the learning design of the virtual lab, where the learning outcomes are represented in the activities designed. We have actually put out a poll with two questions. And what we have found out of 370 attendees, 226 of you all responded. Only a very small number have actually, what do you call it? Own an iPad. Yeah, can you see the results? I've shared the results with the attendees. And yeah. most of them are actually using the iPad for entertainment. So what do you think about these results, Prof. Azma, before I introduce you formally?
Yeah, it's a typical results, eh? Typical results.
All right. Okay. So, everyone, today we have Associate Professor DS Dr. Azma Putra and Dr. Zakia Abdul Halim from the Mechanical Engineering Faculty of University Technical Malaysia Melaka, UTEM. Associate Professor DS Dr. Azma Putra received his bachelor's degree in engineering physics from Bandung Institute of Technology, ITB. Both master's and PhD in sound and vibration from the prestigious Institute of Sound and Vibration Research, ISVR, University of Southampton, UK. PM Azma Putra is also an Apple Distinguished Educator, ABE, class of 2015, and more recently became an Apple Professional Learning Specialist. He's also the proud recipient of UTEM Academic Awards as the winner for innovation in e-learning, which he has received twice, once in 2016 and the second time in September 2020. We also have with us Dr. Zakia Abdul Halim, his colleague, and she has received her bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering from University Technology Petronas and master's in University of New South Wales. She obtained her PhD in Mechanics and Materials from University Kebangsaan Malaysia in 2018. Dr. Zakia is an Apple teacher and the recipient of the Best E-Teaching Portfolio in 2019 in University Technical Malaysia Melaka. She has also won multiple awards in teaching conferences and competitions. So, very good morning to the both of you.
Good morning, Dr. Kumar.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much. I understand that you guys are really busy. Your slot was actually usually at in the evening at 2:30, and so we are making it at 9 a.m. today. So without further ado, I invite Associate Professor T.S. Azman Putra to start your sharing. Over to you.
Okay, so let me share this first. So, can you see the slide now?
Yes. Could you make it full screen, please, Prof?
Okay, this one, eh? All right. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and very good morning. It's a pleasure for us to share again with the Polytechnic community and for all the lecturers and maybe the teachers following this webinar. So today we're going to share a bit on how to create virtual lab easily by using iPad. Okay, so that's the reasons why we asking the poll, do you have an iPad, and then if you have an iPad, what are you using the iPad for? So it's especially the number two is a typical result, yeah? Where one has iPad but doesn't know that the iPad is so powerful to create content. Yeah, it's a mobile device, so you can sit anywhere. You can sit in the cafe learning content. You don't have to sit in the office using your PC to create a powerful learning content. Okay, so that's what we want to share with you today, but in the context of how we create a virtual lab, which is very important in this during of MCO, where the students cannot access the laboratory. So at least we want to have the students to experience the theory behind the lab and what it's like to have certain parameter changing, and then what happened with the outcome and so on and so forth. Yeah. It's halfway between we have the theory and then we have the psychomotor of the students. Yeah, because when the students cannot go face to face in the lab, they cannot have the psychomotor to feel the equipment and to run to press a certain button and so on. Yeah. So this is what we're trying to accommodate.
I think that was also a major concern among lecturers in polytechnics and community colleges. The psychomotor element, how do you teach the psychomotor element during the movement control order when the campuses are closed, you know, there's no access to the lab? So I think that's why this session is really relevant to lecturers out there, especially those of you who are teaching mechanical engineering, actually any engineering courses, right, Prof. Azman and Dr. Zakia? Yeah. All right. Sorry to take it. Yeah, please.
Okay, so we are from Faculty of Mechanical Engineering, so my background is vibration and acoustics. I'm also a vibration analyst category 3, which involves many consultation in oil and gas industry about vibrations, mostly about vibrations. And Dr. Zakia, it's a non-destructive testing. Actually, Dr. Zakia is now in Shah Alam for testing, for certification. So to have a higher degree of level of expert in non-destructive testing. So she's quite busy, and then she spare a little bit of time to present for you all. So
thank you very much. That's an honor.
Does she have an exam at 11? So we pray for her to pass the exams.
Yeah, I'm sure. You know, they say pahala, right? I mean, not sharing knowledge is pahala. So yeah, we wish you the best for your exam. Thank you so much again for spending time with us for this knowledge sharing session.
Yeah, it's always a pleasure for us to share with lecturers and teachers out there. So that's why we don't want to lose this moment. Eh? When you ask us to share, and then we grab the opportunity. Okay. all right. So synchronous and asynchronous. Eh? So the two terms that very familiar become very famous. Eh? During this MCO, during this COVID-19. So yang tak tahu synchronous asynchronous pun jadi tahu. Eh, saya rasa orang-orang kerja dekat universiti pun yang tak ada kaitan dengan akademik pun dah sering dengar juga synchronous asynchronous. Eh. Pasal kita selalu sebut ni. Okay. So synchronous is actually kita boleh synchronous is fixed in time and place. Eh. So meaning we teach we deliver the teaching at certain time. You can have many place. The students can have anywhere, but it's fixed in certain time. So for asynchronous, it's flexible. The students can have their own learning anytime they want in place dia boleh dekat mana-mana. Tapi dia lebih flexible lah. Maksudnya dia time dia dia flexible, dia boleh belajar sendiri. So this is the engineering way to present the synchronous and asynchronous in the table. Okay, so but the problem is now it's not about online learning, but it's when we have a laboratory, yeah, laboratory sessions, kita akan bagi example nanti subjek Dr. Zakia non-destructive testing, which is dia ada kelas, tapi dia juga ada practical yang kena pergi dalam lab. Yeah. So nanti macam mana during this MCO Dr. Zakia try to accommodate that problem, eh? Karena student dia tak boleh pergi lab. So apa yang Dr. Zakia buat nanti yang kita sebut sebagai virtual lab, so that the students can gain the knowledge, eh? Without having to have to going to the real lab. Eh? Okay. So ini dia. So student sekarang dia tak boleh experience the hands on. Eh? So kalau ada praktik pasal welding and so on, dia tak boleh rasa macam mana nak weld benda tu during this MCO. So apa yang kita kena buat? Okay, so this is where the virtual labs is coming to context. Eh? So we're trying to simulate the learning environment so that allow the students to complete laboratory experiment online and explore concept and theories without stepping into physical science lab. So this is a virtual lab yang sepatutnya ideally ada, tapi yang akan kita tunjuk kat sini it's a baru level yang biasa. Nanti the next nanti kita sharing lah, dan yang akan kita share ni adalah lebih kepada engineering. Eh. So engineering it's a bit different with polytechnic, karena engineering kita nak dia faham the concept, eh? Faham the concept and the theory, hands on is only 20%. Tapi kalau polytechnic hands on berapa Dr. Umar? Sepatutnya hands on
30, right? Yeah, 30.
Oh, 30%. Eh?
So that's why I think the issue of not, you know, being able to do psychomotor was really affected most lecturers and students.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So this is examples of virtual lab. Eh? Kalau saya play ni.
And strong acids. So what's the difference between weak and strong acids anyway? In the advanced acids and bases simulation, you'll learn how to distinguish between concentrated and diluted and strong and weak acids and bases. This simulation is a sequel of the acids and bases laboratory. Your knowledge about pH, Ka, and pKa will be tested. Take a look at various acids and bases at a molecular level to understand why they are called weak acids or bases.
Okay, so kalau kita tengok dari video ni, ini sebenarnya virtual lab yang kita nak. Maknanya student akan interact dengan komputer, dia akan kalau ni tadi eksperimen chemical. So macam mana the students can, kalau dia letak, dia campur ni, what happen? Akan jadi apa? So letak chemical yang lain, jadi apa? So everything is virtual. Dia pakai computer mouse saja dekat dia punya PC, and then dia eksperimen dekat situ. So parameter tu dia betul-betul dia tak apa nama dia? Apa yang akan dibuat dekat lab dia boleh simulatkan dekat komputer. Alright, tapi nak buat benda ni, it requires a special, inilah special software, special skills and so on. Dan ini adalah contoh yang saya bagi dekat very commercial company yang jual dia orang punya virtual lab. So kalau tengok harga dia dekat situ, one student per one lab session tu dia charge $60. For one student untuk have dia orang punya virtual lab. Okay, so kalau guess macam ni lah. Ini yang paling ideal. So every student has VR. Tak tahu lagi tahun berapa kita nak punya VR ni. Karena VR sekarang masih mahal. It cost maybe satu VR ni cost $15,000. Kalau dia harga dia jadi murah RM500, mungkin boleh kot student, nanti setiap student akan ada VR ni. So everyone can design the virtual lab. Setiap lecturer akan design virtual lab. So student tak masuk dalam lab pun dia akan experience dekat rumah macam mana lab tu boleh. Okay, so saya akan tunjuk apa yang kami bangunkan. Dan kami bangunkan ini menggunakan iPad aja, menggunakan iPad. Dan juga Mac, tapi mostly dengan iPad. Okay, saya akan share. Okay, so ini nampak Dr. Umar. Okay, so this one is for subject dekat mechanical engineering tahun 4. Non-destructive testing. So lecturer dia tu Dr. Zakiah. Nanti Dr. Zakiah akan bagi detail macam mana step by step nak bangunkan ini. So nanti at least the audience, the participant yang tengok webinar ni dapat idea. Oh, it's not so difficult. And then it is possible for everyone. Okay, so kalau masuk dalam sini, kita bagikan dia dalam 5 main topics. So apa dia punya industrial applications, so pre-knowledge kalau student nak baca dulu dia punya teori, method apa yang available, so boleh ambil, boleh buat task and then boleh buat quiz. So the whole thing is in one environment, one apps. So student tak payah pergi mana-mana lagi, dia masuk sini aja, so dia boleh dapat semua dan dia boleh belajar dalam satu environment. So kalau kita tengok sini, kita pergi industri. Let me.
Non-destructive testing is an effective way of detecting any flaws in a structure. In this module, we are going to expose you to common entity methods that are widely used in characterizing structural defects, especially in the oil and gas industry.
Okay, so this is overview of the application dia dekat mana. Alright, so this is one way the students can interact with the ini. Dia tap, dia ini, so dia tap lagi and then pergi ke application corrosion. Okay, so kalau balik lagi ke home, and then this one is pre-knowledge. So let's say definitions. So the reasons why we want to have the TAPMI here, ini juga salah satu cara kita supaya ada interaksi antara user dengan konten. So kita tak nak masa slide transition aja, so everything is going. So at least dia tunggu dulu, dia tengok dulu, okay apa, and then dia curious, and then dia tap. So this is one thing that we can do to have an interactions between the students and the content.
Non-destructive testing. What is non-destructive testing? There are three elements in defining non-destructive testing. Non-destructive testing is a testing and analysis technique used by industry to evaluate the properties of a material, component, structure, or system for characteristic differences such as defect or discontinuities without causing any damage to the original part.
Okay. That one is a pre-knowledge. Kalau kita pergi ke methods, so ultrasonic testing, kita pergi ke procedure. Let's say kita ambil angle beam ni. And let's go to this one, measurement procedure. Okay, so we can go next. So ini dia punya teori. Macam mana angle beam itu boleh dikira. Okay. So ni kalau ada dia punya voice over ni lagi better. So ni Dr. Zakia belum sempat lagi masukkan dia punya voice over. Okay, so this is the whole idea. The whole idea. So ni kalau kita nak pergi ke quiz boleh. The student untuk test dia punya understanding kan. Okay. So ada soalan and then dia boleh test dia punya understanding, dia buat calculation and then dia jawab, dia jawab ni okay, tak boleh, salah, so next, dia jawab yang ni, okay, congratulations. Okay, so this is a very simple things yang kita boleh buat, so to have the students engage with the content dan dia boleh rasai dia punya, macam mana going into lab. So kalau kita balik lagi pada ultrasonic testing ni, procedures, straight beam, measurement procedure, okay, kita lihat calibration procedure.
Adjust the test reach to the maximum distance you want to inspect. Adjust the material velocity according to material of inspection. Adjust the P delay so that the initial pulse starts from zero. Adjust the D delay so that the backwall echo appears at the end of test reach. Adjust the magnitude of backwall echo so that it reaches more than 80% full screen height.
Okay, so this is what the students have to do in the lab. So adjust ini, adjust itu. So sekarang ni yang kita buat untuk this kind of level. So the student dia paham ini engineering. Untuk engineering dia dia just cukup faham aja dia teori, tapi nanti yang yang boleh kita kita upkan lagi kita punya application ni, student boleh interact, dia boleh dia boleh adjust button ni. So dia student boleh adjust button range berapa, velocity berapa, signal tu jadi macam apa dan semua eh. Itu the next one yang 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 boleh kita buat lah. Tapi untuk sekarang ni kita akan kita bagi tunjuk how is the the concept and the theory behind the NDT in the lab, calibration dia macam mana, apa kena buat dan sebagainya. Okay, so exit, jadi exit macam tu. Done lah, maknanya done. So maybe yang dari saya itu aja, dan seterusnya saya akan pass kepada Dr. Zakiah. So Dr. Zakiah akan tunjukkan step by step step by step, and then kita nak deliver bahawa ini tak susah eh. It's not difficult to to develop this kind of content. It's very easy. So hopefully nanti participant ada some inilah untuk oh this is something which is possible eh. Kita tak nak datang sini participant, so participant akan feel ini susah sangat nak buat. So just ya, kita tak nak nanti selepas webinar ni tak bawa semangat apa-apa eh. So kita nak semangat tu ada bahawa ini something yang which is possible untuk dibuat. Okay, Dr. Zakiah.
Over to you, Dr. Zakiah. We can't wait for you to show us a step-by-step on how to do it. I hope it inspires many of them out there who are watching this.
Okay, all right. Thank you, Dr. Umar. Thank you, Dr. Azma. So, assalamualaikum and very good morning to everyone. Thank you for joining us today. Alright, so tadi Dr. Azma dah show us some of the example of the virtual lab. So, basically, bila saya develop the plan inspector tu, the apps, it started from actually my lecture notes. Okay, so for example, these are my lecture notes. Okay, so saya just ambil pick some. Okay, so what I did during dengan lecture notes ni adalah just modify to add some animation and also the hyperlink from one section to another section. But because in any subject, okay, basically kita ada tiga elemen penting. First is the theory, second is the practical, and last is the assessment. Right? So of course, bila kita develop, kita nak bahagikan dia kepada tiga, right? So even the theory tu pun kita boleh pecah to the subtopic. Right? For example, untuk saya punya lecture notes ni, magnetic particle inspection, right? So dia punya objektif ada tiga. Right? Identify properties, evaluate characteristic and simulate. So this one is kita boleh pecahkan kita bila kita plan for virtual lab tu kepada tiga bahagian, tiga section. So first is properties of the material. So dia mungkin plan diletakkan di bawah teori. Alright, so kita tengok all the content kan. Right, so magnetics contoh. But this one bila kita buat teori, dia lebih senang bila kita ada apa? Animation. Right, so kita tahu, right, this one, the key is actually a magnetic material. But let's say bila kita tap, dia ada animation. So, we can validate, okay, this key is actually a magnetic material. So, in a way, dia adalah interactive and also attractive lah kepada sebab dia ada color, different color compared to just text je kan. Right, so macam mana nak buat adalah okay, saya tengok ada di Q&A ada apa guna apps. Jadi saya akan tunjukkan apps yang saya gunakan adalah Keynote. Right, so kalau siapa yang ada iPad, right, Keynote ni adalah native apps yang yang datang bersama dengan any Apple device. So dia punya ni adalah yang ni lah sebelah gambar Webex ni. Okay, right, so kita nak start adalah kalau kita nak create new lah, right? Once kita create, kita boleh just create a new presentation and choose a theme. Right, so sama macam kita nak buka any, nak buat kita punya lecture notes. Alright, so just start from basic, right? So kita boleh delete everything kosong, alright? And dia akan start dengan fresh blank. Alright, so dalam Keynote kita boleh masukkan shape, kita boleh draw, okay? And kita boleh buat animation. Alright, before saya tunjukkan macam mana nak buat, saya nak tunjukkan animation yang saya nak yang kita akan buat lah hari ni. Saya akan tunjukkan. Okay. So this one is, right, saya akan tunjukkan this animation. Right, there is a magnet. Lepas tu ada form a magnetic field. Okay, and bila kita apply fluorescent ink, okay, kalau there is no defect, so there is no indication. But if we there is defect inside the material, so there will be a magnetic flux leakage. Okay, so when we apply the ink, it will attract the ink will be attracted to the magnetic flux leakage, and then we can find the defect. Right, so these are the animation that we will do. Alright, so alternatively, okay, sebab kita dah tadi dah buka. Right, so this one is how we can add, okay, blank screen. Right, so tadi saya kata kita boleh letak shape ataupun kita boleh lukis. Right, so how to add shape is we can go to the plus sign, okay, to add any shape. Okay, go to the third symbol there, right? So this one is the basic shape. We have basic, geometry, object, animal, nature. So we can choose according to our specialization or our subject. So, but here I only choose, okay, this one to choose as a rectangle, right? So we can change the color. We can go select brush and change the color, right? So a metallic, right? So usually we did the magnetic test, particle inspection on magnetic punya material, right? So this one consider a carbon steel, right? So then tadi kita ada add magnet, because when we do magnetic particle inspection, we need the equipment needed is magnet. So we can use search for magnet, right? So here is the magnet. Okay, so we can make it bigger. Okay, arrange that here. Okay, so if you notice in my example, there is different color. So we can actually change, if we change the color, all right, let's say change to a green, so it will change the whole thing. But we can actually tap here, okay, and break apart, right, so that we can actually change the color for each part lah. All right, so this one, let's say I change into, okay, so this one, because the magnet has north and south pole, let's say this is north and this is south, right, so just to differentiate it, okay. So after we change the color, we should group it again, all right, to make it here. Okay, so we can animate that. Okay, so usually before we magnetize, meaning to say the magnet is far from the plate. So when we want to magnetize, it will animate like this. Okay, so what we can do is tap the animate. Right, so and animate the movement of the magnet. Right, so here we can choose anvil. So in animation, there is a built-in, add action, and build out. Built-in meaning to say from nothing to something. Okay, maksudnya tak ada dalam screen, tak ada. So bila kita built-in, dia akan masuk ke dalam slide. Okay. Build out meaning to it's already in the slide dan kita nak bawa keluar, hilangkan dia. And add action, kita nak tunjukkan pergerakan di dalam slide tu lah. Okay, so for example, okay, bila kita play, right, tadi tak ada, okay, the magnet is not on the slide kan? Tapi bila kita tap, right, kita nampak the movement of the magnet. Alright, so bila kita buat macam ni, right, dia akan magnetize. So this sample dia akan magnetize. So dia akan create a magnetic field. So because of the magnetic field tu, kita boleh lukis. So macam mana nak lukis adalah kita plus add. So kalau kita nak add anything, kita just tambah pada add. So choose to photo here and choose drawing. Okay, you can see there is a drawing there. Right? So kita boleh draw. So draw pun boleh gunakan Apple Pencil. Okay, ataupun kalau tak pun guna jari pun boleh. Alright, but since I have my Apple Pencils, so we can change actually color here. Dia ada color palette. Okay, we can choose any color. Right, so contohnya saya akan guna putih. So I will choose white. Okay, so right, so saya just nak tunjukkan dia ada range. Okay, different ketebalan lah. So depends on kita punya kesesuaian. Alright, so yang mana lebih sesuai with our content, so we can choose or alter according to our content lah to suit that. Alright, so let's say here, saya akan gunakan yang paling besar. Alright, so bila kita ada ni, so magnetic. Okay, magnetic field, so just to create dia punya magnetic field. Okay, so because there is no defect, so dia cuma line dia straight lah. Okay, alright, so macam mana kita nak animate kan? Alright, so we'll tap done. Alright, so we have here S dia punya, okay sorry, dekat sini ada extra. Okay, alright, so how kita nak animate this? Okay, sama juga kita tap on that drawing tadi and animate, and because of the movement of the magnet tu tadi, dia straight aja, so kita boleh straight je lah, buat wipe ke. Okay, so kita boleh change dia punya animation sama ada betul atau tak menepati dia punya konsep tu lah. Alright, so kalau kita buat line draw, for example, if I choose line draw, it's not replicate how the concept of magnetization. So yang paling sesuai the concept of to represent the theory or the concept is guna white. Okay, so dekat sini I choose white. Okay, right, so kita place mula the magnet and then baru magnet keluar. Right, but here kita boleh jadikan dia automatic, meaning to say after dia magnetize je and the line keluar. Kalau tak tadi saya kena tap. Alright, so we can go to the build order, meaning to say after we put the magnet and the wipe will automatically play. So we can go after. Alright, so if we play again. Okay, so it will be automatically play. Alright, okay, so then let's say we want to add another shape. Okay, so we can go into transition, right, because we will using the same concept. So we choose for the magic move. Okay, oh sorry, add transition, magic move. Okay, choose duplicate. Okay, so we are working on the second slide bila kita buat magic move. Alright, so we can delete this because we don't want the magnet. Okay, but we want to add another shape. Okay, which is, okay, say this one is bottle. Okay, so this one kita boleh rotate. Okay, and also change the color. Right, let's say we make it a fluorescence. And also, if you notice this one, okay, this one is from a drawing. Okay, So saya tak nak lukis benda ni. Okay, it's basically just to put you an idea lah macam mana. So this is doable using the Keynote. Alright. So this is meaning to say all the concept can do. We can animate any concept. Okay, and choose the relevant animation available in the Keynote to bring ataupun to visualize any concept that relevant with our courses. Right, so that is first in terms of animation. Okay, so we can put that first in the procedure as a procedure, or also in the virtual test. Okay, but how to break that into first theory and then practical and also assessment, right? In my case, right, so what I did was, okay, for example, kita ada objektif ni, kita nak pecahkan kepada tiga. So we can put shape. Okay, I want to put shape, let's say basic shape here. Okay, this one is the properties of material. Okay, so we can copy it. Okay, let's say kita nak copy and paste, make it. So the next one, the next topic is the magnetic domain. Okay, and the last topic is the steps or procedure of MPI. Right, so basically we can delete this, okay, because these are the three topics that we want, okay, the student to cover. Right, so if we go to the slide, okay, the slide number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, okay, are under the properties of material. So what we can do is tap on that tab tadi and choose link. Right, so we can choose whether it is go to the next slide or link to the slide. So here, the easiest one is choose link to slide lah. Alright, so it is certain that when we tap that, okay, it will direct to our next slide. Okay, here refresher, this one is the objective ataupun what we will do in that section. Identify the magnetic materials of the properties of the material. So here we can get, here bila dekat sini kita boleh tambah another topic, okay, ataupun instruction what the student need to do. For example, next. Okay, and we can also, this one just a simple one, okay, make it back. Okay, maybe the student, okay, wrongly tap on what they want to choose, so they can always go back to the original content. Okay, all right, and also copy, paste, home. Okay, so home is usually this one, the first page to know where they want to do lah. So there is objective. So here home, we go to link and link the slide into slide number 2. So next, okay, link to link, for example, link number 4. Okay, back, we can go to the last view slide. Okay, so we can copy this. Home, next and backs. Okay, copy and paste. All right, okay. Let's move this one, this content. Okay, up. Okay. Right. So this one. Okay. So kita test. Bila kita play, when we tap the properties of material, it will directly to the second slide. So when we tap, okay, so it will go to next, right? So, and the animation, this is animation, okay, the similar animation that I show you just now, right? So dia boleh blinking, alright, the magnetic material tu kalau you perasan dia blinking kan, so that one is the action because it's already in the slide and it blinkings during the animation. Alright, so we can go next.
Dr. Zakia, so
yes,
the magnet here that you have, was it drawn, you know, from scratch, or was it, or did you use an existing icon or clip art available in the in the app itself?
Okay. The shape, okay, the all the objects are from the library. The library
the
in
library.
The
yeah, I forgot that word. Okay, the library. So that means you can also make it interactive, like, you know, let's say students are going to click, are they able to actually click magnetic material? I mean yeah, are they able to interact with the content here?
Yes. Yeah, they can interact, meaning yeah, they can tap so that it will be attracted. So let's say, okay, here I will show you next. Okay, when I touch next, okay, so this one is for, let's say here is the spoon, right? So I didn't do anything, there is nothing, no movement because I haven't tapped it yet. So here now, bila I tap, okay, only then the spoon will move attracted to the magnet. Okay, so but here, there is no tap me yet. So yang tu boleh letak lagi. So we can actually guide the student. Okay, so maybe kita boleh letak dekat sini. And she tap me. So this is just a guidance, right? So copy and paste for every slide. Okay. So bila you tap, only then it will be attracted. So dia jadi colorful and also they can visualize. Oh, okay. So when there is a magnet and it will be attracted. Okay, itu sample yang paling senang lah. So this one is very simple punya. So everyone knows kan? Okay, but bila kita tengok dekat sini, right? So dia ada step, right? So what we can do is put step one, okay? Alternatively, step one, okay? Copy and paste. Step two, right? And link to the correct slide lah, so that it will link us. Okay, this is the first step, for example. Okay, but because this one I haven't link it yet, but because we dia punya slide dia berturutan kan, so dia already play lah. Okay, so there is no defect. Okay, so step one, step two, and step three. So the basic of the MPI, there is three step. So step, so that there is important part in the theory. Okay, bila kita buat any virtual lab, ada one part when we put list down all the procedure. So the first one is and it will supple with audio. So it will help the student to know what are the first step, what they should do first, what are the equipment they should need, and how it is carried out. So bila kita buat all the step 1, 2, and 3 and supple put on the audio, and then it will help the procedure or any virtual test to become more interesting lah. Alright. Okay, so is there any question nak tanya? So I guess that is a very simple demonstration on what we can do virtual lab only from our slide. Actually, for basically we already have all the content. Okay, so there is what we have to do is just cluster it according to whether it is theory or we cluster it according to the subtopic and then rearrange that. Okay, so that it will be very interactive and engaging content.
Thank you for sharing that, Dr. Zakia. So sorry for the interruption. So thank you for sharing that, Dr. Zakia. So you have actually shown an important concept, which is based on the learning objective, you plan out your contents. I think that's a very critical area. So I think many of them would like to see what other images you have in the library of the keynote.
Okay.
We're trying to see, okay, how are they able to use it for their, you know, for their subject. Yeah.
Okay, we have, okay, basic geometry. Okay, this one, or object. Okay, but if we don't have the object in the library, we can actually draw it. Okay, so because this one, I just show the line drawing, but, right, so let's go to the library first. Okay, this is the example of one object. Okay, so animals, if you are teaching life sciences, okay, nature or food, we have also so symbol here. Okay, education, arts. Science, okay, look. Okay, people, places, activities. Okay, so there are a lot of symbol lah ataupun shape yang kita boleh gunakan, right? So it is also already built in the library. Okay, so let's say something, the object that we want is not in the library. Okay, so we always can have draw it. Okay, so what are the example? Let's say we want to draw let's say kita dalam ultrasonic. Masa tadi yang I buat ultrasonic tu, there is no dia tak ada dia punya dalam simbol ni. So we can draw, okay. Let me try. Okay, this one, let's say this one is ultrasonic sensor. Okay, we can go and try the image. Okay, so let's say these are the sensor that we want. Okay, so we can, okay, kita cari yang lain senang sikit. Okay, let's say this is the sensor that we want. We will just drag and drop. Okay. Okay, let's say this is the sensor that we want. Okay, so can reduce the opacity. Okay, and draw it. So let's make it here. Okay, I make it very fast. So dia mungkin agak kurang cantik sikit. Okay, so here. This line here. Okay. So we are done. Right? So kita boleh cut or delete it. Okay, so dia nampak tak cantik kan? So actually kita boleh edit and color it. Okay, here is dia punya color tool, right? So kalau kita nak nampak dia sama, alright, kita boleh color, put that color, alright, or change a bit. Okay, All right, so now we have a sensor. All right, so something, even though there is shape that we want to teach them, it is not inside the library, we can always draw it. So it becomes ours because we create the content, we draw it, even though we copy or tracing it from the existing picture.
Thank you for that, Dr. Zakir. So there's an important question here from Encik Muhammad Zaki. He teaches electric wiring. So adakah possible untuk kita hasilkan virtual lab yang pelajar boleh buat pemasangan some of the electric components? Kalau salah pasang, dia akan tulis salah. Kalau betul, dia akan proceed. Adakah possible untuk kita buat virtual lab untuk wiring menggunakan keynote? Itu soalan dia. Sama ada Prof. Azma atau Dr. Zakir, mungkin?
It is possible, but we have to plan the link tadi. Okay, tadi link tadi kan kita ada the link to what slide, right? So whether it is next slide or the number of slide, so we can plan the link. Okay, if the student tap on the wrong choice, okay, it will go to sorry, you make it wrong or buat gambar terbakar. Alright, so we can make it. So kalau misalnya dia pasang betul, okay, contoh yang tadi untuk for example, okay, so tadi, okay, this question, okay, kita tunjuk tadi, Dr. Azma ada tunjukkan on this, okay, test, right, so this is basically soalan saja, tapi kita boleh buat macam ni, right, let's say this one is changed to the color of your electrical wire, so let's say this is the color blue and red, so if the student choose blue, so, okay, kita tukarlah supaya, okay, so this one, kita change the color to red, okay. Okay, so if the student change the color to blue, so it will say sorry, try again. Okay, so if we choose red, okay, so it's still sorry. Okay, so dekat sini kena tukar color juga. Alright, let's say this one is the different color. Okay, so the correct one is, let's say, is the yellow one. Alright, so we can congratulate him or ataupun kita boleh jadikan dia the next step lah. Alright, so kita kena plan. Okay, kalau if the student step this color, it will link to the different slide. So we can create. So that's why when we do the visual lab, we have to craft it ataupun plan it supaya this slide will link to the next slide, which slide, so that it will basically when they do everything correct, then finally it will show the ideal condition of the any concept. Tapi kalau misalnya they choose or different ataupun value yang tak betul tu, nanti dia akan lead to wrong punya calculation ataupun concept lah. So kita boleh alert them. So but basically bila kita buat create virtual lab ni, one thing that we have to bear in mind that everything yang kita buat is according to the ideal condition. Okay, so of course it based on the theory. So kalau the ideal one, bila student dah dapat, dia akan buat practical lah. Tapi kalau misalnya student memang tak boleh untuk buat practical, apa yang kita boleh buat adalah bila dia punya discussion tu, what kita boleh tanya in terms of higher order thinking, what are the things yang they consider akan menyebabkan their results in experiment is different from the ideal condition. So kita boleh tanya macam tu lah, what are the potential influence sama ada influence daripada instrumentation dia really. Okay,
thank you, thank you Dr. Zakia. Dr. Azma, would you like to add on to that?
Mungkin tak tahu.
Would Dr. Azma add on to that? Would you like to add on to that?
Okay,
ada ini Dr. Zakia ada elaborate. Tapi cuma yang saya nak bagi emphasize sikit, dengan keynote ni kita, masa kita tunjuk tadi, interaction-nya adalah touch and go. touch and play, touch and play. So this is the kalau kita nak pakai keynote ni, this is something that we can do. Tapi kalau kita nak lagi advance, macam sensor tadi, kita nak student untuk touch dan alihkan pakai jari dia ke mana dia nak. Eh, so this is require another webinar. Itu ada sampai lain. So kita nak buat. So kalau ni konsep-konsep yang ada yang ada yang sepatutnya kita nak design dalam kepala kita dengan menggunakan keynote is touch and go. Eh? Macam yang electrical wire tadi, ada berapa pilihan kita bagi student touch ini, so nanti electric itu akan bergerak sambung macam ni, dan salah beritahu salah. Eh? So dia pilih lagi touch lain, so dia akan bergerak sambung on lampu atau whatever. Betul. So satu-satunya itu yang boleh kita buat.
So ada satu soalan. So how do you all use it in your teaching? Do you all use it during your synchronous session ke during asynchronous session? Where do you all use it?
Okay, so yang the last yang kita nak bagi tunjuk, boleh saya share slide?
Boleh.
So macam mana sekarang kita nak share pada student kan? So itu yang jadi dia punya soalan kan?
Yeah.
Macam mana kita nak share berjadi pada student? So okay, saya tunjuk dulu yang keynote tadi. Ini nampak. Okay, so dekat sini, ini dalam keynote . Yang kita buat ni dalam keynote apps, makna kita jangan bagi student keynote. Pasal nanti dia orang boleh edit dan tekan mana-mana terdelete ke atau apa deh. Dia tak boleh kerana this keynote is something yang editable. Kita kena bagi dia dalam bentuk something which is dia tak boleh edit. So dalam keynote ni kita boleh export dia. So pergi pada file, export to, okay, keynote kita boleh export dalam PowerPoint, so tak ada masalah. Export dalam movie, makna dia akan play sebagai movie lah. Dia tak ada interaction, makna student tu dia tak boleh interact kalau dia dah movie kan. Dia tak boleh tap whatever and then dia bergerak and so on. Animated GIF ni lain. Ini kita nak buat orang berjalan, nak buat burung terbang dan sebagainya. Animated GIF ni session dan lain lah. Images, ini yang kita nak, HTML . So kita akan export ni dalam HTML. Okay, so next. So create an HTML document that can be viewed with Safari or another web browser. So next, kita tekan next and then dia akan export ke HTML. So nanti kita boleh uploadkan dalam kita punya website. So saya tunjuk ni kita punya website. So ni dah dalam website . Ni dalam website http://coreacity.com virtual lab index.html. So ni dah dalam website. So nanti student kita bagi link website ni, so dia akan interact through website. Okay. So ni semua touch and go yang tadi yang kita buat tadi semua dah ada dekat sini.
Satu lagi soalan, nanti sebelum kita akhiri sesi ini, how do you all actually observe your students' achievement menggunakan this way of teaching? How do you know your student have you found out how effective this is for your teaching and learning? Have you done any research about that?
Ini Dr. Zakia ni, Dr. Zakia.
Okay, so basically, this one is actually I've been using this slide for two semester lah. Right. So the feedback daripada student memang sangat dia punya feedback adalah dia sangat menarik dan we can see from their understanding bila dia jawab soalan. Okay, so bila dengan dia punya walaupun dia tak hands on the dia punya equipment itself, okay. So tapi because of dia punya animation tu, it helps them to answer dia punya quiz tadi, the assessment. Okay, because it related with the interpretation. So kalau dia tak faham in terms of dia punya on the on the practical punya side, dia punya calculation tu nanti akan they cannot do the calculation part. Right. So walaupun because usually I bagikan virtual lab ni before dia punya session. Dia punya synchronous session. So this is considered a synchronous punya session lah. So dia boleh buat bila-bila masa, dia boleh, sebab ada yang tanya macam mana kita nak make sure student tak skip everything. Okay, dia actually kita bagi pada student, student boleh buat ataupun pilih dan belajar bila-bila masa apa topik yang dia nak belajar, sebab sometimes student ni dia tak ada background langsung on NDT, tapi ada yang dah pernah tahu what is NDT, so dia boleh skip part on the theoretical part, so it's okay. But later on bila dia masuk ke part yang dekat practical tu, sometimes dia akan start, oh they need some theory, some equation, so they can go back to the pre-knowledge ataupun the resources, the bahagian teori tu tadi. So it is easy for them to cari, okay, bila kita dah linkkan to the dia punya actual slide lah. So dia akan jadi macam apps yang macam apa, dia depends pada student bila nak buat, okay. So dia lebih kepada student centered lah, right. So ada juga soalan daripada chat yang saya baca tadi, tanya macam mana kita nak pastikan dia ada rubik penilaian. Okay, basically saya belum ada lagi in terms of okay, macam mana nak tahu sama ada student tu memang dia dah tak skip sama tu, tak ada. Tapi from the feedback kita boleh tengok daripada assessment at the end tu nanti, memang student tu dapat jawab, kalau dia follow all the slide, memang dia boleh jawab all the question.
Okay. Thank you so much, Dr. Zakia. So, Prof. Azma, I think you would like to summarize the whole session, maybe? I can see a slide there.
Yeah. Okay. So, what we have shared, it's creating virtual content dengan iPad atau Mac. Eh? So, it's not only iPad. Eh? Kalau saya rasa lecturers politeknik dekat sini banyak yang punya Mac. So dekat Mac juga dah datang keynote apps, eh. So boleh pakai keynote apps untuk buat content. So we create engagement between the student and the content dengan tap and go tadi. Tap and play. Eh. And the content can be accessible through the website. Eh. So kita convert dia dalam HTML. Lepas tu kita pub dekat website dan kita share pada student. Even kita boleh tak share pada student pun, kita boleh share to the whole world. Yeah. Kita boleh share pada student-student yang lain yang interest dengan. So it can be you punya content, which is you build your credibility to international level. Okay, so that's it, Dr. Umar. Cuma tadi yang satu ada soalan. Okay, tak apa. Ini saya jawab aja semua. So ini masih banyak lagi. iPad kita boleh gunakan untuk create the content, eh. Dr. Zakia belum share lagi macam mana nak buat voice over, masukkan suara kan, masukkan kita punya voice. Lepas tu kalau kita nak buat video content, kita boleh export lagi jadi movie. Dan kita nak edit content, kita pakai apps iMovie which is free juga dari iPad, kita boleh edit dia terus. So in only single device iPad tu aja kita dah boleh buat banyak benda, eh. Ada music, kita nak create our own music, ada GarageBand, so it's free juga dari iPad. Kita tak nak pakai music orang lain which is copyright kan. So free dari iPad kita pakai. So tadi yang paling simple thing tadi yang apa tadi, drawing, eh. So drawing kita kena hati-hati, ambil dari Google, masukkan dalam slide karena reflect. Karena kita akan publish nih dekat website, so kita tak nak ada orang komplain nanti this is copyright, kenapa tak ada permission and so on. So kita boleh draw kita punya image sendiri. So it's become ours lah. So itu tak payah worry dengan itu. Tidak tahu lah, so hopefully it's full of all the lectures.
Okay, so unfortunately we are out of time today, which means we might have to have another session maybe in our our upcoming webinar series, where maybe you can share more how to, as you mentioned just now, how to integrate audio, how to integrate a voiceover for the animations, and then so that it inspires more lecturers at polytechnics and community colleges to be content creators themselves. Yeah. So I would like to thank both presenters for joining us today and providing your first-hand experience. This now concludes our session today. Thank you, everyone. So the next session starts at 10:30, and we have a teacher from all the way from Penang, and she's going to share how to increase interactivity using four apps in your live teaching sessions. So I'll see you at 10:30. Thank you so much, Prof. Azma. Good luck for your interview later in the evening, and Dr. Zaki, all the best. I hope you pass your exams with flying colors. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Duma. Okay, bye.
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 Stop recording then.